Hey, this is Dr. Carlo Oger, emergency physician and founder of DrER.tv. Now, while you're sitting there just waiting, go ahead and click that subscribe button.
Awesome. Thank you.
Hello, guys. Dr. Carlo here. In this video, we're going to be watching wax plug removal using the elephant ears, which is a spray bottle. You buy it out of Amazon. I'm going to put the link in the description below. It's like $40, which is a lot for a spray bottle. But hey, it beats going to the doctor and getting this done. It's extremely easy to do. There are a couple things that you should never try to do. Is if there's any kind of blood or drainage, any chance that that tympanic membrane is being ruptured, you have tubes in your ears or anything like that, because spraying water at high pressure can rupture it more, can push water in or whatever. But if you have a simple earwax and you really can't get it in, you shouldn't be trying to get it in because you can create some damage. This water irrigation technique is awesome. Bought this water bottle called Elephant Ears, and it would just works great. As you can see in this patient's case, we did the right ear, which didn't have that much wax plug, and then at the very end, you're going to see this big wax plug that came out of the other ear. I'm sorry I did not get that part of the video there, but you can see how the process is really simple. You just put that little catheter wire into the ear and just start flushing. Eventually, it breaks it up, and the pressure itself pushes the wax out. I hope you find this useful, that you'll learn that the technique is really simple to do, and you'll learn not to. You'll see what happens. Take care, guys.
All right, so what we're doing is getting ready to do an irrigation of cerumen impaction. We introduce this, it's called elephant ear. And we already did the other ear, and it went really well. Patient has to wear these earplugs for work that you just got me all wet. All the cerumen. You want to aim it a little higher?
Yeah, a little bit.
Killing me, Smalls.
I know, it's not my fault. This one's like...
It's definitely breaking up some because it's kind of a little yellowish. I'm not picking up the phone. Okay, try and wiggle a little bit, but we're not squirting me.
Wow, then
turn and
wiggle.
I think I'm gonna flunk you up there.
Please don't. Then you have to deal with me another couple months.
That's true.
Yeah.
Now, sometimes the pressure by which you pull the trigger is how much pressure goes into the ear.
Okay, so maybe I need to do it a little bit.
Okay, go. Going kind of deep there. Got it.
There goes something.
The cord is to show people how to use this device here. Let's see where we're at. Take it out.
We got a little chunk, but that was it.
No,
you wanna
let me dump that.
Dump that. There we go.
Yeah, it's breaking up eventually, it'll come up. So pull that a little harder, like when you squirt. Actually, like. Yeah, like you're mad
Dr.
at it.
Dr. Hajibor, call 1168, Dr. Hajibor.
Sorry, I'm just trying to.
It's a piece. Come on.
I'll fill it out.
Okay, it's still fill out. I'm just gonna dump it. So we got some. Oh, I just did that.
Oh my goodness. Right there, I was trying to show the patient the wax that was in the water, and I spill it right on her lap. So embarrassing.
Is that because of us putting all the fluid in there, or is it because of the impaction?
It's probably from the impaction itself making it irritated and such.
Okay.
Yeah.
So let's talk just for a minute about the patient's clinical presentation. She presented to the emergency department because she was either at work or driving and she felt really dizzy. And it was hard to define whether it was just lightheadedness or spinning type movement. But one of the things that can cause dizziness or trouble with the middle ear in terms of balance problems is having a foreign body in the ear canal, sometimes even hair laying against the tympanic membrane, having a middle ear infection, or even a cerumen impaction. A cerumen impaction is when the wax plugs up. This particular patient at work has to use a special device to protect the ears for hearing damage and stuff. And that basically creates a pressure and makes the buildup of wax even more packed and hard to get because it's deeper down. And that's what was wrong. When I went in to look into the ear, there's a lot of wax there and plugged in. Left much more than right, but they were both seriously impacted with cerumen. And because I thought that was the cause of the patient's symptoms, I decided to go ahead and do that clearance using this elephant ear. The patient's plug went away. We used a Q-tip to dry it up, and she felt much better. Now, we also gave her fluids and some medication, so I'm not sure which one worked best, but she definitely felt a lot better after having done this procedure. I can tell you, a year ago, I would never even have tried to do this in the ER because it takes so much time to do the individual syringes, to inflate, push, and to fill up the syringe with water and push and get it out. It's just extremely difficult, time-consuming, and the whole process is just nasty. And you have sicker patients in other rooms, and you have a lot of things to do, but using this device is so easy to do, so satisfied to really get this done that I had, hey, we got to give it a try. Plus, I have a nurse practitioner student with me, so let's show her how to do this procedure and get it done. And as you can see, we got the wax out of both ears. I re-examined the ears, went in and took another look, and they were clear. Patient felt better. So that's it.
Hey guys, thanks for watching this video. Now go ahead and go to DrER.tv.